As early as 1928, a sophisticated model of a society's optimal saving was published by the British mathematician and economist Frank Ramsey, 1903 to 1930. Ramsey's contribution was mathematically demanding and did not experience much response at the same time. Three decades had to pass until his contribution was taken up seriously by Samuelson and Solow in 1956. The model was fusion with Solow's simpler growth model that came out in 1956 and became a cornerstone in neoclassical growth theory from the mid-1960s. The version of the model which we present below was completed by the work of Cass in 1965 and Koopmans in 1965 again. Hence, the model is also known as the Ramsey, Cass and Koopmans model. We can think Ramsey model as an improvement over the Solow model. Some general comments about Solow model are following. This is the first general equilibrium model with the production side. It has a very strong predictions that are empirically testable. It lacks micro foundations, that is, savings is not determined exogenously. Exogenous technological progress explains all. Ramsey model makes saving rate as endogenous by introducing consumer optimization in the neoclassical model. So, Ramsey model provides micro foundation to the growth model. Advantages of Ramsey model over Solow model are following. Consumption and savings are determined endogenously. The decentralized equilibrium, that is the problem of households and firms, can be compared to the socially desirable outcome, Pareto optimality. But stronger analytical tools are needed because the problem of consumers is intertemporal.
After studying this module, you shall be able to know the problems with the Solow-Swan model of economic growth and how Ramsey model improves our understanding of economic growth. Learn the Ramsey model of economic growth. Identify the key factors for economic development and evaluate and analyze the dynamics involved in economic growth. Consumer. 1. Infinitely lived household that maximizes intertemporal utility. The household receives wage income in exchange for its labor services and interest income for its accumulated assets. The income acquired is directed in purchasing goods for consumption and in savings through the accumulation of additional assets. Population growth rate is constant and equal to n. L, which is a function of t with the dot symbol on the top, is divided by L, a function of t. This entire term is equal to n. Let us mark this equation as S1. Firm. The economy consists of a large number of identical firms producing a homogeneous consumption good Y. The production function of each firm is given by YT, which is a function of KT and LT, marking it equation S2. F of K and L satisfies the neoclassical properties and pays wages and rent in exchange for labor and capital services respectively. We also assume that production function is linear homogeneous. In a closed economy, output is exhausted by household consumption CT and investment IT. So, YT is equal to CT plus IT, marking it equation S3, where we have assumed that government consumption is zero for now. Aggregate gross investment is the sum of replacement investment and the net addition to the capital stock. That is, IT equals to delta KT plus K dot T, marking this as equation S4. In the Ramsey model, there is finite number of agents with an infinite time horizon. Further, these agents are completely alike. The Ramsey model is thus a representative agent model. Assume that the representative consumer is infinitely lived and blessed with perfect foresight. The consumer experiences instantaneous utility, felicity, which depends on the consumption flow, CT. The utility function of consumer is U, which is equals to U of C of T. Marking it 1. The properties of instantaneous utility function U of C of T is 1. It is increasing. That is, first derivative of the utility function should be greater than 0. And second, it should be concave. That is, the double derivative of the utility function should be less than 0. This satisfies the Inada conditions, that is, limit n tends to infinity, the first derivative of the utility function of C of t is equal to 0, marking it 2, and limit n tends to 0, first derivative function of the utility function of C of t equals to infinity, marking it 3. The consumer derives no felicity from the consumption of leisure and is assumed to inelastic supply LT units of labor to a competitive labor market. The lifetime utility function of consumer is given by delta T equals to integral from 0 to infinity of U of C of T exponential raised to the power minus rho T into dt, marking it 4, where delta T is the lifetime utility function and rho is the pure rate of time preference. From the assumptions of model, the income of consumer from financial assets and labor will either consume or save. So, budget identity of consumer is C of T plus A dot T equals to R of T multiplied by A of T plus W of T multiplied by L of T, marking it 5, where A of T is financial assets, R of T is rate of return on financial assets, and W of T is the wage rate. Aggregate consumption, that is C of T equals to CT multiplied by equals to C of T multiplied by L of T. Now, define A of T equals to capital A of T divided by L of T, marking it 6. Differentiating equation 6 with respect to T, we have D of A of T divided by DT equals to D of A of T divided by L of T, the whole divided by DT, which is equals to L multiplied by D of A of T divided by DT minus A whole multiplied by D of L of T divided by DT, this whole divided by L square, marking it as equation 7. This is equal to A of T with a dot on the top divided by L of T minus A of T upon L of T, the whole multiplied by L of T with a dot divided by L of T, marking as 8. Now, dividing equation 5 by L of T, we have C of T divided by L of T plus A of T with a dot on the above divided by L of T equals to R of T multiplied by A of T divided by L of T plus W of T, marking it as 9. A of T with a dot on the above divided by L of T equals to R of T multiplied by A of T the whole divided by L of T plus W of T minus C of T with a double brief on the top, marking it as 10. Where C of T with a double brief on the top is equals to C of T divided by L of T. Now, subtracting A of T divided by L of T multiplied by L of T with a dot on the above divided by L of T from both the sides of equation 10, we get A of T with a dot on the above divided by L of T minus A of T divided by L of T multiplied by L of T with a dot on the above divided by L of T equals to R of T multiplied by A of T the whole divided by L of T plus W of T minus C of T with a double brief upon it minus A of T divided by L of T multiplied by L of T with a dot over it divided by L of T, marking it as equation 11. Now, by using equation 8, we can write equation 11 as A of T with a dot over it equals to R of T multiplied by A of T the whole divided by L of T minus A of T divided by L of T multiplied by L of T with a dot over it divided by L of T plus W of T minus C of T with a double brief over it, marking it as equation 12. A of T with a dot over it equals to R of T multiplied by A of T minus N A of T plus W of T minus C of T with a double brief above it, marking it as equation 13. A of T with a dot over it equals to R of T minus N within one bracket multiplied by A of T plus W of T minus C of T with a double brief above it, marking it as equation 14. To avoid economically nonsensical outcome, we need to impose a solvency condition, that is, limit T tends to infinity, A of T with an exponential integral ranging from 0 to T of R of tau minus N the whole multiplied by d tau equals to 0, marking it as equation 15. Intuitively, equation 16 says that the consumer does not plan to expire with positive assets and is not allowed by the capital market to die hopelessly indebted. Problem of household is to maximize delta t, which is equal to integral ranging from 0 to infinity of u of c of t exponential raised to the power minus rho t multiplied by dt, subject to A of T with a dot over it equals to R of T minus N the whole multiplied by A of T plus W of T minus C of T with a double brief above it. The current value Hamiltonian function H bar equals to U of C plus lambda R minus N the whole multiplied by A plus W minus C, marking it equation 16. First order condition of optimization is delta H bar divided by delta C equals to 0. This implies delta H bar by delta C equals to U dash of C minus lambda equals to 0, marking it as F1. Delta H bar over delta A equals to rho lambda minus lambda dot. This implies R minus N the whole multiplied by lambda equals to rho lambda minus lambda over with the dot over the top, marking it as F2. Delta H bar divided by delta lambda equals to A with the dot over it. This implies R minus N the whole multiplied by A plus W minus C equals to A with a dot over it, marking it as F3. From F1, we have lambda equals to U dash of C, d lambda by dt equals to U double dash of C multiplied by dc by dt. This implies that lambda with the dot equals to U double dash of C multiplied by C with the dot over it. This implies that lambda with the dot over it divided by lambda equals to U double dash of C multiplied by C with the dot over it, the whole divided by U dash of C, marking it as equation 17. From F2, we have R minus N the whole multiplied by lambda minus rho lambda equals to lambda with the dot over it. Lambda with the dot over it equals to rho lambda minus R minus N the whole multiplied by lambda. Lambda with the dot over it divided by lambda equals to rho minus R minus N, marking it as equation 18. Using equation 17 and 18, we have U double dash of C multiplied by C with a dot over it, the whole divided by U dash of C equals to rho minus R plus N. U double dash of C multiplied by C with a dot over it, the whole divided by U dash of C equals to minus of the whole expression of R minus rho minus N minus U double dash of C multiplied by C with a dot over it, the whole divided by U dash of C equals to R minus rho minus N minus U double dash of C the whole divided by U dash of C the whole multiplied by C multiplied by C with the dot over it divided by C equals to R minus rho minus N. We have theta of C multiplied by C with the dot over it divided by C equals to R minus rho minus N, marking it as equation 19, where theta of C equals to minus U double dash of C multiplied by C the whole divided by U dash of C is elasticity of marginal utility, which is positive for all positive consumption levels because of strict concavity of U of C. C with a dot over it divided by C equals to 1 by theta of C the whole multiplied by R minus rho minus N. C with a dot over it equals to sigma of C the whole multiplied by R minus rho minus N the whole multiplied by C. This is equation 20, where sigma C equals to 1 by theta of C is intertemporal substitution elasticity. Intuitively, if sigma C is low, a large interest gap, that is R minus N minus rho, is needed to induce the household to adopt an upward sloping time profile for consumption. In that case, the willingness to substitute consumption across time is low. The elasticity of marginal utility is high, and the marginal utility function has a lot of curvature. The opposite holds if sigma C is high. Then the marginal utility function is almost linear, so that a small interest gap can explain a large slope of consumption profile. Equation 20 is known as Euler equation of Ramsey model. Representative firm. Perfectly competitive firm produce a homogeneous good by using capital and labor. Since there are constant returns to scale to the production factors taken together. Production function is given by Yt, which is a function of Kt and Lt marking it equation 21. The stock market value of the firm is given by V of t, which is equal to an integral ranging from 0 to infinity of f of kt lt minus w of t multiplied by l of t minus 1 minus s multiplied by I of t, the whole multiplied by exponential raised to the power minus r of t, the whole multiplied by dt, marking it equation 22, where r of t equals to an integral ranging from 0 to t of r of t multiplied by d of t, which is a discounting factor. I of t equals to delta k of t plus k of t with the dot over it is the gross investment. Delta is the depreciation rate. S is the investment subsidy. We can write equation 22 as V of t equals to an integral ranging from 0 to infinity of f of kt lt minus w of t multiplied by l of t minus 1 minus s the whole multiplied by delta k of t plus k of t with the dot over it, this entire expression multiplied by the exponential raised to the negative power of r of t and the whole multiplied by dt, marking it as 22.b. The solution of the equation will be V of t equals to k of 0 plus integral ranging from 0 to infinity f of kt lt minus w of t multiplied by l of t minus r of t plus delta the whole multiplied by k of t. This entire expression multiplied by exponential raised to the power negative of r of t and the whole expression multiplied by dt. This is equation 22.c, where k0 is initial capital stocks. The marginal productivity condition for firms will be fl is a function of kt plus lt, which is equal to wt, marking it 23a. F of k is a function of k of t and l of t, which is equal to r of t plus delta, marking it equation 23b. If we substitute equation 23a and 23b in equation 22b, then V of t equals to k of 0. So, in the absence of adjustment cost on investment, the value of the firm equals the replacement value of its capital and Tobin Q. In the intensive form, F of K, which is a function of K of T and L of T, equals to F dash K of T, marking it 24A. F of L, which is a function of K of T and L of T, equals to F of K of T minus K of T multiplied by F dash K of T, marking it 24B. By using equation 23 and 24, we can write R of T equals to F dash of K of T the whole minus delta. This is equation 25. Equilibrium in the Ramsey model. We have following equations. Y of t equals to C of t plus I of t. This is equation 26.1. I of t equals to delta K of t plus K of t with the dot over it. This is equation 26.2. And L of t with the dot over it divided by L of t equals to n. This is equation 26.3. Now, dividing equation 26.1 by L of t, we get Y of t divided by L of t equals to C of t divided by L of t plus I of t divided by L of t. We get small y of t equals to small c of t plus I of t divided by L of t. This is equation 27. We have I of t divided by L of t equals to delta k of t divided by L of t plus k of t with a dot over it divided by L of t. This is equation 28. Now, differentiate k of t divided by L of t with respect to t. We get d k of t divided by L of t, the whole divided by dt equals to small k of t with a dot over it, which is equal to L into dk by dt minus k into dl by dt, the whole divided by L square, which is equal to k dot divided by L minus k by L multiplied by L dot by L, which is small k with a dot equals to capital K with a dot divided by L minus nk. Capital K dot divided by L equals to small k dot plus nk. Substituting in equation 28, we get I of t divided by L of t equals to delta k of t divided by L of t plus small k dot plus nk. This is equation 29.a. I of t divided by L of t equals to delta small k plus small k dot plus n small k. This is equation 29b. Substitute in equation 27, we get small y of t equals to small c of t plus delta small k plus small k dot plus nk. Small k of t with a dot over it equals to small y of t minus small c of t minus delta plus n, the whole multiplied by small k of t, marking it as equation 30. Now, combining the problem of the firm and the Euler equation, that is equation 20, we get small c dot equals to sigma of c, the whole multiplied by r minus rho minus n, the entire term multiplied by c. This is equation 20. Substitute equation 25 in equation 20, we get c dot equals to sigma of c multiplied by f dash of k of t minus delta minus rho minus n, the whole multiplied by c. This is equation 31. We now have all the ingredients of the model and we summarize them in following table 1. Table 1, Ramsey growth model, is c of t with a dot over it equals to sigma c of t multiplied by f dash of k of t minus delta minus rho minus n, the whole multiplied by c of t. K of t with a dot over it equals to y of t minus c of t minus delta plus n multiplied by k of t. In the steady state growth rates of per capita consumption and the capital stock per worker equal 0, that is c of t with the dot c of t with the dot over it equals to 0 and k of t with the dot over it equals to 0, and we have c dash equals to f of k dash minus delta plus n multiplied by k dash, f dash of k bar equals to delta plus rho plus n. So, the growth rate of per capita output is also 0. Result, In the absence of technological progress, the Ramsey model predicts zero growth as in the simple Solow-Swan model. Dynamics in Ramsey model. Dynamics of consumption growth rate, C dot equals to sigma C of F dash of K of T minus delta minus rho minus N, the whole multiplied by C, that is equation 31. If C dot equals to 0, then F dash K equals to delta plus rho plus N. Let K star be this level of K. When K is greater than K star, this implies that F dash K is less than delta plus rho plus N, which implies that C dot is less than 0. And when K is less than K star, it implies that F dash K is greater than delta plus rho plus N, which implies that C dot is greater than 0. Therefore, when the capital stock increases, the consumption growth rate is diminishing. We can show this by figure dynamics of capital accumulation. K of t with the dot over it equals to y of t minus c of t minus delta plus n, the whole multiplied by k of t. When k of t with the dot over it equals to 0, then c equals to y minus delta plus n, the whole multiplied by k. And let c star to be this level of c, we have delta c by delta k equals to f dash k minus n plus delta equals to 0 for maximization. So at maximum value of c, f dash k equals to n plus delta. So will increase until f dash k equals to n plus delta. This is the golden rule of k, denoted by kg. If we increase k beyond kg, then consumption will decline, as shown in figure. If c is greater than c star, then f of k minus n plus delta, the whole multiplied by k, is less than c. This implies that k of t with the dot over it is less than 0. And if less than c star, then f of k minus n plus delta, the whole multiplied by k, is greater than c. This implies that k of t with the dot over it is greater than 0. We can represent the dynamic of capital accumulation using figure graphical solution of the system, which is the phase diagram. The graphical solution of Ramsey model in figure K star is defined by F dash K equals to delta plus rho plus N, and Kg is defined by F dash K equals to delta plus N. Since F double dash K is less than 0, that is another condition, then K star is less than Kg. So K star, which is the level of K that implies C dot equals to 0, will be lower than the golden level of K, that is Kg. If economy is on saddle path, then only economy will reach to equilibrium point.
The Ramsey, Cass and Koopmans model differs from the Solow-Swan model in that the choice of consumption is explicitly micro-founded at a point in time and so endogenizes the saving rate. As a result, unlike in the Solow-Swan model, the saving rate may not be constant along the transition to the long-run steady state. In the absence of technological progress, the Ramsey model predicts zero growth as the simple Solow-Swan model.